appreciate them all, you know. Like I said before, it's a lot of people that you can feel their energy. You know, you can feel their energy, and people always show fake love, you know. And it's easy to show certain things when a person is on top, but when they fail, that's when their true colors come out. And people don't know I'm an energy being. I felt many people before, and it's only confirmation. So when they thought I failed or been to the ground, you know, it's only confirmation for me to see them, the aftermath of that. And I appreciate that, you know. Now I know how to treat them moving forward. And they'll feel it as well, too, you know. So I love the critics, because when you're doing great, you know, people are always going to be with you. But when you do bad, like I said, they're going to show their true colors. And I keep my grass cut all the time at this moment in time. You know, it's always hard for me to trust, but at this point in time, I trust none of them. And I appreciate them for giving me that confirmation of them, showing their true colors. Here I am, now I'm back, and it's no stopping me now. I tell them good luck. You know, no, I won't even wish them luck. I probably wouldn't say nothing. My silence has been golden, you know, and I plan on keeping it that way. People don't understand, but what's understood don't have to be explained, you know, and I keep it that way. I'm going to do all my talking come October the 9th. Prince, but just one king, you know, and I am the king. I visualize myself being on top of it until I retire, you know. I don't have much time I want to spend in this sport, and I want to fulfill my dreams and my goals as being the undisputed champion, collecting all the belts, and after that, we can talk about retiring. Too early to say, you know, sometimes certain things come your way that make you change your mind sometimes, man. But but retirement is definitely something that that's in my future. I can't say when. I can't say once I unify it, because I do feel like I want to defend it a couple of times. I always said I want to grab all the belts, defend it a few times, and then retire. So I think I'm going that line, and we'll see what happens. You know, right now the future is bright, and it's too far away to tell at this moment in time. But know that I am thinking about, you know, my planning of retirement once I accomplish and achieve all my goals. That's why everybody should appreciate me while I'm here, because when I'm gone, I'm gone. I'm not coming back.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, most enough. Everyone loves a comeback story, and I feel that with my story that already that's been laid down, that how I got into boxing and you know, doing it for my daughter that was born with spinal bifida, promising her that I'll be a champion when she was 1 year old, and pursuing that and grabbing that, then coming and to come to a defeat and then come back. You know, it's gonna be an amazing story. I can see movie scripts been written out, and movies been played from this. This comeback story, so you know, that's the power of a certain thing that people love, comeback stories, and I think this is going to be a great one.
So this is the longest layoff in your
life. Amen.
Focus.
It's been amazing to me. I mean, I'm a loner, you know, as is. I love being at home. I'm a homebody as well. So with the pandemic and everything that was happening in the world, it was peace for me, you know. I have my happiness at home because all my family that I hang around is always around me. So it wasn't nothing for us, you know. It was something that rejuvenated me. It's something that was well needed, you know. And it allowed me to get back into the sport of boxing, and now I was just ready to go. And now that we're here, even with the delays of this fight, it's supposed to been happening a long time ago. It was okay for us. You know, we was good with it.
and we continue on with our, you know, happy ways of laughter and joy and positivity and love that's around us. And it's still, as you can see now, we're still able to have fun amongst each other. And I'm ready to go. You know, I'm ready to go from here. I feel real strong. I feel very confident in what I'm going to do come October the 9th. And I just can't wait to give it to the world.
Does it matter what Tyson Fury does? It's all about what you got to do in every
game. It's all about what I got to do. It's nothing that he does good that is going to stop me off, stop me from doing what I got to do. You know, it's all up on me. You know, at the end of the day, these guys go in.
Watch out for the rocks.
Yeah, that's what I was
going to do. Yeah, I was good.
That's what I was going to do.
Thank you.
Support weight, and listening to my spar partner, getting a lot harder than I ever hit before. So I'm looking forward to punishing him and then knocking him out.
Talk about love and life. Did you feel the energy in the last fight? Did you notice something weird
to
meet other fighters?
Yeah. The whole arena, just the atmosphere all the way around. You know, not only did I feel it, but my team and everybody was around. We all had different stories of how we felt. Something just was weird. Something just didn't feel right like it usually feel. But it's all good. You know, now we're more protected all the way around. And I'm looking forward to it.
Last one, so you are feeling the love this time. Is this totally different for me than the first fight you're going to do?
Oh, most definitely. You know, we're just more protected. You know, I can say, many people want to know what I mean by that, but again, what's understood don't have to be explained. Blessings. Yes, sir.
So there you have it. Another great video for ES News. For ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Elie Seckbach, reporting, and you can follow me on Twitter, at Seckbach. And you can follow me on Instagram at Elie Seckbach.